Dear graduates, or should I say excited graduates, your parents, your guardians, and those who have supported you throughout your training at Moi University. Today marks an exciting day where you end a journey of hard work and commitment and begin an equally exciting journey in life that hopefully will be crowned with a lot of successes worthy of the hard work you have invested in your training, whether it's undergraduate or postgraduate level. My name is Professor Mabel Nangami. I'm an Associate Professor of Health Policy and Health Systems Management and also the Dean of the School of Public Health at Moi University. Again, congratulations and a warm welcome. The School of Public Health was started in 1998 as an Institute of Public Health. It then transitioned to a School of Public Health where we started our first undergraduate program, Bachelor of Science in Environmental Health. We have then grown since that time to have several programs, and we've also had over 20 years of experience in training public health practitioners as well as professionals in the area of public health who are already working in the field. Currently, the school is located in town campus of Moi University, next to Moi Teaching and Referral Hospital. The school is part of the four schools of under the College of Health Sciences. That is the School of Medicine, which was the parent school, the School of Nursing, as well as the School of Dentistry, and then the School of Public Health. We are nested in the Public Health, Dental, and Nursing School building, which is, as I said, next to MTRH and near the town center. The School of Public Health vision is to train health professionals who have competences in public health, and these competences will not just help them to solve today's problems, but more importantly, to address emerging as well as future challenges in public health. Not to mention, of course, the coronavirus, the COVID-19 pandemic that has visited upon us a lot of disruptions in the field of public health. I'm delighted to mention that the School of Public Health currently hosts about 20 staff members, as well as about 8 non-teaching staff. In total, we have about 5 programs that have been accredited by the Commission for University Education. And of course, among these is the BSc in Environmental Health, which is our flagship program when we started off. It was the first program in East and Central Africa, the first ever in the area of public health. Of course, since then, we have many universities in our country as well as the region that are offering BSCs in various fields of public health. Beyond that, we recently had a Bachelor of Science in Health Informatics that was also approved and is awaiting review by the Commission for University Education. We have several master's degrees. The pioneer master's degree was Master of Public Health in various specialization or options. For example, we have the options of epidemiology and biostatistics. We have the option of health services management. We have the option of health promotion. We have the option of human nutrition, as well as disaster risk management. All these have been carefully selected to provide competences that will address the contemporary problems in public health, not just in the country, region, but internationally. We then have a second master's program, the MSc in Field Epidemiology, which is another flagship project that allows us to collaborate with the Ministry of Health, as well as other partners who are supporting us, such as KEMRI and CDC. We are proud that this program focuses on training those who are already in service, meaning we have a multidisciplinary background of doctors, dentists, laboratory professionals, nurses, all of them coming together to train in the field of field epidemiology, which is really the applied epidemiology that enables us to prepare you to address pandemics such as the COVID-19. And I'm proud to mention at this stage that our students have been instrumental in working with the Minister of Health to address the COVID-19, whether it's through surveillance, whether it's through tracking of contacts, and among other activities that they are engaged in. Lastly, we are also in the process of approving an MSc in infectious disease and global health. Again, this is a very unique program that we are proud of, not just as a school, because we have partnered with the University of Nairobi, and we are keen to offer this degree because, again, it addresses the contemporary issues of public health, and in particular, addressing the age-old problems of infectious diseases such as malaria, but moving on to those, the current ones such as COVID-19, but also looking at the global perspective. What are these public health problems that afflict us that have a global nature? And if, again, we use the example of COVID-19, you can see that it's a problem that has affected the entire globe. So this course is probably going to start next year. And again, we welcome you to be part of this training through the various advertisements and applications that will come your way very soon. I would then like to move on and mention that in terms of student numbers, we have a very unique philosophy in terms of teaching research as well as service provision. The College of Health Sciences prides itself in working with the SPICES model, which essentially, in summary, means community-based education and service, but also taking a problem-based learning approach, where you start from a problem situation and work backwards to say, what do you need to address or solve this problem? It therefore gives the learner, puts the learner at the center of the learning process, but more importantly, that pursuing of how to find a solution allows them to work in multidisciplinary teams, so that even in the training, we are integrating the knowledge within the various disciplines that form not just public health, but medicine and health in general. So we also have, as a School of Public Health, take pride in the second philosophy, which is the One Health approach. The One Health approach is also important for us because, as you know, the transmission of diseases is no longer just human to human, but over time we are seeing a trend of transmission from animals to humans, and also in the process of addressing this, we need to take care of the environment and ensure that we are sustaining a healthy environment. So the fusion of animal, human, and environment is also critical in how we train and prepare our graduates. Again, we pride ourselves that our curricula, of course, then cover these two philosophies, the SPICES model, and also the One Health approach. And we are also in the process of establishing a center of excellence that will not only use these approaches, but in so doing, try to strengthen the health system and support the government efforts under Vision 2030, but more importantly, also towards the Sustainable Development Goal number 3. Allow me then to move on to talk about the numbers. The School of Public Health, as I said, started in 1998. Our intake, therefore, based on the philosophy, is small numbers, small group learning, where we try to promote your interaction with the fellow professionals in an environment that allows you to appreciate other professionals and the role they play in caring for patients or delivering quality healthcare. So having said that, it means we have numbers such as 20 for our intake for undergraduate. Of course, we at times get to about 30, depending on the demand. But generally, most of our programs, including the masters, we try to restrict ourselves to a number where we can promote that small group learning, that interactive process, and also managing the experiential learning, where the learners go out and learn in the community, and more importantly, they go to the industry. So for us in public health, the biggest industry, of course, is the health facilities. But beyond that, we have related areas where we also train our students, and they do this almost 30% of their learning time. They are out in the community or in the industry learning how to apply the knowledge that we have provided while they are in the classroom. So having said that, it means currently we have as a school over 1,000 alumni, and we look forward very soon to having an occasion at the school and celebrating the achievements of our alumni who are out there. For the ones in master's level, we also have in each of these programs about an intake of 20, and particularly for the field epidemiology, the Ministry of Health cannot afford to draw the workers from the field in large numbers. So we work with a number of 20 to ensure that there is no disruption of service delivery at the county level or in the other facilities that they could be engaged in. We know there is a very high demand for these programs, and there are plans underway to ensure that we embrace fully online teaching, working with blended, of course, teaching, but moving on to most of our training to be online, including examinations as advised by the University Senate and Council. Allow me to mention a few of our alumni, where they are placed, what makes our program attractive. I would say that most of our alumni, about two-thirds, are absorbed in government. Particularly for master's program, it is much higher, almost 70%. But for the undergraduate, I would say about two-thirds work in counties, and the other third then work with NGOs and other international research bodies. For example, currently we have one of our alumni, Dr. Esther Njoroge, who was recently promoted to be the Vice President of Global Medical Program that is actually based in New York. She works between New York and Kenya. And that is a major achievement of seeing one of our alumni in our master's or public health program excel, or, you know, be able to get high up on the ladder and be a vice president of a global program. There are many. There is another student, alumni, who was the director of Ifakara Institute in Tanzania. And again, we take pride in seeing how Fred Ross climbed the ladder and has also completed his PhD and is even teaching at reputable universities that are collaborative. We also have, as I said, all our programs are multidisciplinary, particularly the public health masters. So we also have journalists who have come to us and trained. Some of them are even more university alumni from other programs. And I would mention one BBC journalist who is currently based in DRC Congo, Anne Soi, who has also done a master's of public health, and she's doing exemplary work in reporting on public health disease outbreaks and related health issues. We also have of major interest alumni who are working with NGOs within the country, and this include World Vision, CARE International, Kenya Red Cross, JAPEIGO, just to mention a few. And as I said, the bulk of our graduates are working in counties. We are proud to mention that the chief officer of Nyamira County, for example, is our alumni with a pharmacy background. There is one also with a dentistry background who is working in Kisii. And we appreciate that all these achievements and quality alumni that we have trained at the School of Public Health could not have been achieved without the excellent partnerships that we have with our North American partners, just to mention Indiana University, Purdue University at Indianapolis, Duke University, Johns Hopkins University, University of Toronto in Canada, as well as many others such as Brown University in the US. All these are collaborators who offer our students and scholars scholarships to train, but more importantly, support and mentor our staff to also be their best. Some of the collaboration include joint curricula and also visiting professorships, and we look forward to growing some of these areas, including upcoming new programs, as I said, with the aim of setting up a center of excellence to define the niche of the School of Public Health at Moi University. In Africa, we have a flagship project called the Africa One Health Universities Network, AfroHUN, and this is involves about 9 countries in Africa and about 18 universities and research institutions, again promoting the philosophy I mentioned of One Health, where we engage students who go out to fields, demo sites in our country as well as other countries, to demonstrate the excellence in how we can work with animals and humans and environment to ensure that we bring public health to the fore of government agenda in addressing the challenges and the many diseases that plague us. Allow me to then wish you well. My message to you is that as a new graduate, you are going to face many challenges. You have this a culmination of a lot of hard work and commitment and passion, but those alone will not take you beyond where you have reached. You need to sit down and reflect and have a strategy. How do I climb up the career ladder? How do I find an appropriate job? How do I, if you are have a basic degree, BSc Environmental Health, how do I define my niche in public health? All this will happen if you think of a strategy, organize yourself, but still have the passion. And in so doing, just be nice to other people. It does not help to hold grudges when you fall down. And fall down you will. Stumbling you will. Making mistakes you will. But that is the essence and the difference of those who go down and those who pull themselves up. Pulling yourself up requires that you define your character and identity as part of that process. My best wishes as you join the community of public health practitioners as undergraduate degree holders as well as master's degree holders. Thank you very much and my best wishes. God bless you. Think big.
Thank you.